scripture. I've preached from it several times. My ministers have preached from it several times. And it's relative to what we just went through, amen?
Amen.
I will tell you, God has a way of doing things.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Esther, for making me see. I appreciate your service so very much. We've gone through, my brothers and sisters, a treacherous storm.
Amen.
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 A storm like we've never seen before.
Amen.
Lives were lost. Material possessions were lost. I'll tell you that we can get those back.
Amen.
Lives we can't get back. Nobody wants to go through a storm.
Amen.
Especially the type of storm we just had.
Amen.
It was devastating. In the lack of words, it was an awesome, awful storm. It put the cities in bondage and captivity.
Mm-hmm.
It even had us in our own homes captive to our own home.
Amen.
Amen. It was just awesome, awful. Amen.
Amen.
But the storm is gone. The storm is over. The question is, what do I do now that the storm is over? We know that materialistically wise, tangible wise, we can file for our insurance, we can file on a claim. We know what to do physically. But what do we do spiritually?
Come on now. Right.
Now that the storm is over.
Yes.
Let me just share with you a few things about the storm. Storm that happened in people's lives. If it had not been for a storm, Jonah would still be a backslider. All people of Nineveh would be lost. If it had not been for a storm, Elijah would not have met Elisha.
Right. Yeah.
If it had not been for a storm, Peter could have not walked on the water.
Yeah.
If it had not been for a storm, the disciples would not have witnessed the miracle of peace as Jesus spoke gently to the wild situation.
Yeah.
If it had not been for a storm, Paul could not have preached the gospel on the island of Malta. When we come out of on the other side of a storm, we can say to God, like Job said in Job 23 and 10, but God knows the way that I take.
Yes.
And when he has tested me, yeah, I will come out like pure gold.
All right.
My brothers and sisters, sometimes storm has a way of testing us.
Yes.
And you will agree with me that we've been tested these last week and a half.
Yes.
Have we got a witness?
Yes.
We have maybe even questioned God. God, do you see what we're going through? Do you see what's happening here with us?
Yes.
Even though storms are frightening, they are painful, and they are unpredictable, they are necessary for our spiritual growth.
Yes.
See, somebody here, you have learned something from this storm spiritually.
Yes.
And I'm going to share with you some things that we should be doing now that the storm is gone. But but storm has a way of teaching us something that sometimes we get so busy. Hello, somebody. We get so busy in our everyday life that we don't even pray. Even after God had delivered them,
yes, sir,
through the storm. Storms have a way of sending people to their knees in prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Nice and warm.
Amen.
Nobody have time to pray. But soon, when the storms of life come into our lives, suddenly we begin to pray.
Amen.
Everybody's content,
yeah,
in doing our own thing.
Uh-huh.
Doing this and we're doing that until the pain come crushing down. Until the tidal wave of wind and rain come in our lives. And we sometimes we begin to cry out like Jesus. Like the disciples of Jesus. Master, don't you care that we'll perish?
Yeah.
And I believe that somebody sometimes during this storm, we question God. God, do you care? Do you know where we are? Do you know what's going on in our lives? Certainly God knew.
Yeah.
Have I got a witness?
Amen.
As I look back over this story here, it's strange that what I find most noteworthy in this text that we just read, not about the storm, not about Jesus calming the storm, or Jesus being angry because of the lack of faith, or the fact that they will marvel at what Jesus did. But what's so interesting is that these disciples who were part of Jesus' closest inner circle did not worship him or praise him after he calmed the storm. Read the text. They didn't even say thank you. And I'm afraid that some of us today, we have. Something happened on Those nine lepers made it through the storm, but they forgot Jesus is more than Lord of the storm. He's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. And we need to be reminded of who he is. It was the Lord that kept us.
Glad you asked.
Can I share with you the sacrifice of chicken breast?
All right.
It's not anything tangible. Well, it is something tangible. It's not any money. Amen.
Amen.
It's not any food. Amen.
Amen.
It's you.
Amen.
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 It's you and I. You and I can be the sacrifice that we give God. Well, what do you mean, Brother Preacher? Let me just share with you Romans chapter 12, verse 1 says. It says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. What am I saying? I'm saying that since God has brought you through the storm, now you present your body, your life, as an altar, as a sacrifice on the altar. You be the sacrifice. You give your life to God now. Amen, I said, well, that's the means of showing God that, God, I'm thankful for what you did in my life. I'm thankful for how you brought us through the storm. So I'm going to give my life to you. I'm going to stop playing church. Hello, somebody. I'm going to stop being an imposter in the church. I'm going to be the church. I'm going to surrender my life to you because you brought me through the storm. The house couldn't keep me. Hello, somebody. The car couldn't keep me. It was you that brought me through the storm. So I'm going to give you my life as an offering. Haven't got a witness? I'm going to stop faking church. Amen, last one. The man was so tormented, so outcast, so messed up that he lived. giving God the glory
Amen.
That belongs to him. Ironically, my brothers and sisters, it took a messed up life. It took a tore up life. It took a broken up man who was possessed with legions of demons to show those of us and disciples what to do after the storm. And what he did after the storm was that he ran and worshiped Jesus.
Amen.
What are you going to do after the storm? Are you going to continue doing what you're doing? Now that everything is cool, now the water has resided, what are we going to do now? Oh, we know we're going to file our application, we're going to file our lawsuits, but what are you going to do? What are we going to do spiritually? Are we going to keep on staying home? Well, what will you do? Will you offer God some thanks, or will you complain or whine about what you don't have?
Yeah.
Amen.
All right.
Do I have a witness in the building?
Amen.
Well, what are we going to do? Are we going to offer God our life? Are we going to offer God? What are we going to offer God? Are we going to keep on living the way we desire to live? What are we going to do? Will you offer God worship? Ever the reverence, the honor, the devotion, the love he deserves. God loves you.
Amen.
What are you going to offer him? He deserves, or he was filled. Listen, God do not want us to steal his glory.
Amen.
He wants us to give him glory and honor. The last thing I share with you is offer him some worship.
Amen.
God, I'm going to worship you. There's a difference between praise and worship. See, you can praise him, amen. You know, you can worship him and not make any noise. But you can't praise him and not make any noise. I wish you had a witness. But you can't praise him and not make it at all. God, I don't want us to give our lives to him, but he also wants us to praise him by showing him some gratitude, and he wants us to worship him. Jesus is our model. The Bible declares that he came down from heaven. He came down from heaven that we might have an abundant life. That's what the Bible says. He says in John 10:10, the thief come to steal and to kill and to destroy, but I come that they might have life and they might have it more abundantly. Jesus wants us to have an abundant life. He don't just want us to live. Hello, somebody. He wants to live in abundance of joy. His name is Jesus.
Yeah.